Okay, good afternoon friends. So as you know, we are here to talk about one program that we are going to start, that is of essay writing. Now, if we talk about essay writing, all of you know me, and every year many of my students are getting selected. Many of them come to me and tell me that what we did in the classes, like if you are aware, I'm very, very famous for answer writing classes, and very much famous, although I feel ki sometimes things are, you are victim of success. So sometimes what happens, you become very popular for something and other things which are even better, people know less about you. So whatever, they tell me that many of the things we did for the answer writing classes, they were very, very useful for the essay writing, and they scored very good marks without doing much, and they were still able to do well in the essay. And this makes me think, what is different, what we are doing for essay writing? Because one thing is pretty much clear, if I look into the preparation cycle of a UPSC student, we find that in general, about, depending upon which optional it is, you are spending about 50 to 60% of your total preparation time on optional. Some can even give more, they're giving more. Like for example, in general you'll be finding geography students, they're even giving more. Reason being, probably because geography covers very large portion of your GS, so there you need not study very special things, unique things or separate things, so there it is covered. So it is mixed actually, but whatever. And rest, if you talk about, you are spending in study of general studies, you are spending in your current affairs. One of the things which continues to get neglected, it is clearly essay. Like for example, this year you will be finding overall the marks range, there was range from high to low. In general, I found the range was where students more tend to be there was between 90 to 140 marks. This was the range which was there. So I found many students getting just marks somewhere around 90 marks, while there were others who were scoring 120 plus, 130 plus, 140 plus. And again, you can see that this is actually a huge range. It is range of 50 marks. And I can make you meet students, my own students, who just missed the bus, final selection I'm talking about, by 3 marks, 4 marks. Although they scored very good marks in their optional, one of my students, it was his last attempt, and he has scored 299 marks in geography optional. But he did not do so well in the essay and one portion of GS. Also, the interview marks were not so much high. As a result of which, he is missing the cutoff, final cutoff by 3 marks. And hopefully we know that he'll be in the reserve list, that is one thing that is positive, but still he could have been in the list. In fact, you can understand if he would have just got 25 more marks, he would have been within the top ranks. That is the range, you can understand, and you can very clearly see how much essay, if you talk about, is important in this sense. So if we talk about from this perspective, in fact, we very well know that we always say this when we are teaching, that optional and essay, they are like key in scoring ranks, getting that good ranks. GS is no doubt, it will be giving you marks which will make you come in the list. Okay, so from that perspective, essay becomes the key if we want to be in those ranks. Also for selection, you can understand. Now, we will find that as I told you, one of the neglected area is the essay. What we do, we are spending so much of time in, for example, I give an example of my optional geography. So in geography, you'll find that students are spending so much of time in study of just paper one. If they give 1/4 of that time to essay, you will see how much marks jump you will find. At least you are guaranteed you'll be jumping at least 20 marks. And that is from this perspective what we are doing. We are going to start this program. So if I just talk about this program, what this program is all about, I'll be talking number of things, other things, but what this program is all about is, it is a practice, essay practice program. Because if you ask me, because you'll find number of essay classes going on and number of things would be taught there. If you ask me, I don't think that you need any specific content preparation for essay. We'll be talking some content with the example essays that we'll be taking. But if you ask me, because I find students running behind some books, specific books for essay to read, there is so much content already inside you. You have already studied here so much extensively general studies. You also have studied your optionals in so much depth. Why you need more content? From that what you have studied, from your practical reading that you are doing every day, like for example, you are reading your newspapers every day. From that what I can do? I can come up with a very, very good content. I already have so many examples. I already have so many cases that I am reading on everyday basis. And if you look into the essay, like for example, if you look into last year's 2018 paper, you will be finding it was just trying to test what practically you have learnt. There will be people, there will be teachers. Like for example, I am a geography teacher. So there was one essay on climate change. There was another essay on border management. So to emphasize that my subject is very important, I would say that, okay, this, if you study geography, you could have done this in this essay, you could have written this in this essay. Like for example, one was essay on customary morality. Again, if suppose a philosophy teacher is taking, he will talk about, see, you should be knowing about what is customary morality, how it is different from other forms of morality. That is very important. But as a GS student, I don't think it is very much important, because very important thing that we will see, I have been talking about this phenomena again and again, that any kind of writing is what? Any kind of writing is a communication. So when we'll talk about essay, because this is just an orientation class, first class I will be talking about what are the basics of the essay, so many things I'll be talking about. One thing that we'll see, it is very importantly that no matter what type of writing you do, it is what? It is a form of communication. It is a form of thinking. The thinking that we are doing, we are communicating to someone. And when you are communicating to someone, can I ask you one simple question? If you are sitting here and I ask you I start speaking in Mandarin, will you understand? You'll not understand, because you are not Chinese. So you don't know the Chinese language. So it is about what? It is about communication. I have to communicate in a way, the person who is reading, he is what? He is my listener. The reader there becomes the listener. And he should be able to understand. And you tell me, if I ask you, can I say that essay is part of general studies? Can we say that? So if it is part of general studies, you tell me very importantly, can I say the person who will be checking my answer, he will be a generalist? Can I say that? Essentially, he will be a generalist. So how can you expect that he will be very much adept, he will be very much aware with the technical, many of the technical, because any term you use, there would be a popular conception and there would be many other type of technical conceptions which would be there. So how I can assume that that person, that teacher, he would be very much aware with all the technicalities of the topic? I cannot be sure. I have to take that general part into my mind. In fact, if I talk about my own experience, I have shared this experience with students. They have shared their experience of the essay writing with me. And we always find that we generally tend to choose essay on the basis of our subject or optional bias. Many times it happens. And what we find, it is not paying rich dividends in the examination. We tend to become or come towards the average. Because what I felt from my own experiences, also from the experience of students, was that we generally tend to become too technical when we have knowledge of something. Like I found there were students this year also, they started writing on border management and they also introduced some of the theories of borders in the essay. Again, you can understand. Their marks, I found, it was not. 110 was not a very good marks in the essay. I would say 130 plus was a okay, good score in essay. But if you are lying on 110, it is not a good score. So probably one of the basic reason was that you became too technical. And this is one big mistake we are doing in the essay. Why? Because, like for example, I'll demonstrate later on that there can be questions which we feel, on the surface we feel that we don't know. But if we just think, if we just relax, if we just think, we will find that probably those topics might be more closer to us from practical point of view. Probably, because as a student, if I talk about how much actually I am about, So this essay was asked this year, 2018 if you talk about, and this essay was, like for example, there was question on alternative technologies for climate change resilient India. Okay. And I am very sure if a student is a geography optional student, he will choose this one of this essay as one of the topics he will think on writing. But can I ask one simple question? Of all the students or geography students who will be writing this essay, how many of them would have actual experience in the alternative technologies? Very few. Will they be able to write practical problems that would be encountered? Very few. Similarly, there was this management of Indian border disputes, a complex task. You will be finding that how many of you would have managed borders? Will you be able to write your practical things? Will you be able to write your experiences? Because essay is what? What experience tells me, essay is more about personalization. Giving my own opinion. Essay examination is a type of a very subjective paper where UPSC is trying to judge your character, your personality. It is, if I have to just compare, I would say it is a personality test before you go for the personality test. And many people will, they have opinion that optional is like, for example, it is testing your personality. No doubt it is testing, but by essay it is tested more. In fact, even before ethics paper was there, UPSC was testing your personality through the essay paper. And if you are choosing this type of topics, which technically you would have studied as a part of subject, you are unable to show that personality. And why? Just because I didn't had habit of taking out what is inside me just because I didn't have habit of sharing my experiences, thinking on my experiences, which I am all seeing every day in my life, which I am every day reading in the newspapers. So, suppose if I just ask you, can I say this was another like, a good life is one inspired by love and guided by knowledge. Can I say this was one topic? If I actually think, I will see later. If I actually think, I will find that it would be more closer to me. Because that is what I have been trying to learn throughout my life. So I've been trying to live a good life. And I've been told that a good life is what? I will be able to live if I am educated, if I am knowledgeable. So many things I will find very close to me. Even I can cite some examples. On daily basis that is happening. Similarly, like for example, this essay was there. Customary morality cannot be a guide to modern life. So, customary morality, custom, some morals which are customary. If I go into the technical meaning of customary morality, I'll find philosophy mein there is customary morality and it talks about it is wholesome. So, what you think, you also act. That is basically what? That is customary morality. But was that the essence of this topic being asked? Were they asking you that technical things? They were not. They were more concerned about you thinking from your practical life examples. Like for example, if I had to write, can I say, I am finding so many examples every day that is taking place. Whether it is if you talk about related with women, Sabarimala issue. Can I say, I had read extensively and can I say, many of the customary morality which was there, it was a part of customary morality that women cannot enter that temple. Can I say, it is not compatible with the modern life? So many other examples on daily basis we are finding. We are even seeing around us, so many things are taking place. Can I say, I could have found a way, if I think properly, I could have found a way where I could have justified that customary morality is incompatible as well as compatible. What are the things with examples which are incompatible? What are the things which are compatible? It was just about that thinking. And what is the problem? The main problem is we haven't learned the technique, this technique of thinking, this technique of evolving. We haven't practiced enough. If we would have practiced enough, we would have our own style. We would have developed our own style of writing. Like for example, soon Shivansh will be here. He will talk about, he had developed his own style of writing. And that paid very good dividends. He got 140 plus marks, which is very good marks. And it has been very much decisive in his selection. And what happened? Just because I had not practiced. What we are doing? We are not giving adequate attention to this topic of essay. Although, even with, it is like if I do the cost-benefit analysis, I will find just giving this limited time and it can improve my marks drastically. The same, usi ke liye I would be like struggling from years, same amount of marks increase. I would be struggling for years in my optional and still I am unable to increase. But a little practice and you can be there. That 20, 30 marks which you are missing. That is the power. So why it is happening? Why? Because it is very clear that we are not focusing on the basics of essay writing. We are not practicing enough. So if I was like, for example, writing the examination, it should be my routine that I am writing at least, I am saying, at least two essays in a week. And I am also able to properly evaluate. Here that becomes the problem because sometimes what happens, many times in fact, majority of the times in fact, that we will write and there is no guide available to ultimately judge where we are. And whether what we were writing, it was up to the mark or not, although we will have an idea. But still, so if I was writing, it would have been my objective that at least I am writing what? Two essays, and at least I am getting some input on what I have written, or at least I am getting some framework of what could have been the way of writing. And from that I can evaluate myself even. If required, I am evaluating myself and giving myself marks and judging whether I lie in A plus category, I am lying in A category, B plus category, B category. And if you are aware, you would be able to do this. There is no problem. So if I talk about this guidance essay writing program, first of all, it is not a teaching program. Here there is not going to be any teaching. We will talk about the content, what would be the frameworks, what could have been the meaning of the keywords that are used in the essay. Many of the contemporary essay that we will be taking up, which we feel that can be asked any time, because they have been in news. We'll be also talking about the content of those. But what is the spirit of this program? The spirit of this program is not to teach you something. The spirit of this program is to break your inertia. Why this problem is happening? Because we tend to be in the inertia. Because what is the problem? When we start writing, suppose I take a pen and I start writing my essay, what I want to do, I want to produce a world class essay. And it is very much like, abhi pani mein ghuse nahi, and I want to beat Michael Phelps. It is something like that. So what we have to do, we have to break this inertia. And this program, we are just going to give you direction. We are just going to help you break this inertia. So what this program is going to be about? This program is more about, like for example, it is a thematic essay writing program where number of themes we will be taking. We will try to replicate the type of essays which are being asked in the examination today, where the theme tends to be, the title of the essay tends to be becoming more philosophical. Although they have to be solved from those simple, our practical knowledge purposes, from the practical point of view. And we will show that how it was just what about being more practical. So what we are going to do in our program, it is very simple. We will take up at least two topics. We'll be writing at least two topics. You know very well, Saturday, Sunday, 2 days are there, the classes will be there. And in these 2 days, what we'll be doing, we'll be just picking up two topics. That means on Saturday, we will take two topics. On Sunday, we will take two topics. So by this, what we'll be doing, we'll be in total, in a week, solving four essays. And at the end of the week, ultimately, there is also a test. So there are, in fact, 4 weeks program it is, and it is supplemented by the test, where it would be like the UPSC test. Okay, so that is what you are going. That means in a week, if I include the two essays that you will be writing, in a week, actually, you will be writing how many? 6 essays. And it is, as I said, 1 month program, 4 weeks. So this means its sole objective is to break the inertia. And once you are through that inertia, I know that you will be able to do this task on your own. Because up till the examination comes up, every week, what you have to do? Every week, you have to take out time to at least write 2 to 4 essays. That is the best preparation of essay which you can do. No doubt, we will talk about the principles that would be there, that we'll be using. Like for example, I'll just give you one example. When I'm talking about principle, I have taken test even in my optional classes from the students of essay also. What I find, when this type of test is given, suddenly you just get a pen and without much of thinking, what you do, you simply start writing. You just have an idea. If you majority of the cases we find we have already ready-made content available. That is why I said I'll find many students just choosing that climate change topic, because there is already ready-made content available. No matter how much ready-made content is monotonous, not close to you, it is not your, but because it is ready-made, just you'll start writing. So we will learn this through so many examples, every example essay that we'll be taking. So here, what we will be doing, like for example, we will see when we are writing essay, the first step of writing essay is choosing the topic of essay. And when I'm choosing the topic of essay, at least I should be spending what, 5 to 10 minutes of that time on choosing of topic of the essay. So we'll see, for example, when I'm talking in the class, I will demonstrate you that as a student, as a person, what was the thought process which was going on? How I chose the essay? Like for example, here, I was saying that alternative technologies, but again, I felt my thought process would be, many of the things which I will be writing in this topic would be what? I wouldn't have seen them. How I can think about many of the practical problems that would be going on? So probably I might not be able to come up with that good content. I will choose another topic. So choosing the topic, then the next stage comes, it is the brainstorming. Now, brainstorming also, if you know, you will be able to do it better. If I know my mind, I will be able to do it better. For example, we will see that brainstorming, for example, in the essay, I am getting 1.5 hours. That means total 90 minutes to write one essay. Now, in this 90 minute, ideally, if I take some 1,000 words, suppose I am writing 1,000, 1,200, whatever I am writing, I think I will be able to write this much words in 50 minutes. Can I say? Can we write 1,000 words in 50 minutes? We are already doing for the GS and more than these we are writing in 50 minutes. That means I have got 40 minutes for this and this. Now, when you have got this 30 minutes, suppose for brainstorming, there also there are stages. If I know my mind, I will know very well that first of all, the ideas flow very randomly. When I start thinking on some topic, ideas begin to flow what? Very, very randomly. Too much randomly. So what we find that when we are doing brainstorming, there is 3 stages of brainstorming. This is being done in 3 steps. And what are these 3 steps? First is the stage of random brainstorming, where I am just randomly thinking on the topics, the words which are there in the topic. And I will be able to come up with number of things. But this random brainstorming would be very random, because it is nature of my mind that ideas flow very randomly. Then will come what? Then will be the second stage. Once I have those things, now I can pick out what would be the headings of paragraph. What would be the approach that I will be taking in the essay? If I have already decided the approach without doing that random brainstorming, that means very clear, I might be missing many of the points. I might be missing many of the viewpoints which are there. So what I will do, I will think about what would be the approach, what would be the sequence of these paragraphs, where I will decide in the second stage. I will clear out, okay, these are the things that is going to be my headings. This would be the sequence, this is the approach I am going to take. Once I have got this, can I say the third stage of brainstorming would come, and this is sequential brainstorming here, or that is, I will simply call it as the topical brainstorming. Now what we have got? We have got already the framework. I have to just think more, even think examples to justify what I am saying. So I will look into these headings and I will find out what are the things which I can write inside it. And if I am able to do this work in 30 minutes, my essay, can I say, is already ready? It is very clearly ready. So if I just take one example to demonstrate this, I am finding this, I take this essay, customary morality cannot be a guide to modern life. ठीक है, here can you read this? Customary morality cannot be a guide to modern life. Can I say there is already an idea present? There is already a viewpoint which has been put forward that it cannot be a guide to modern life. Can I say it is not necessary? I fully agree with this idea. Can I say that? Agar pehle se hi mere dimag mein, I am thinking like today what is happening, there is Sabarimala issue is there in my mind, and others like Khap Panchayat, others, so many things are taking place. If I just have that biasness already in my mind, first of my response would be what? I would agree with the statement. Okay. And it is very much possible that my entire essay would become just justification of this idea without looking into the second dimensions which could be actually there. So what I have to do? I have to pick up the keywords and I have to start my brainstorming process. So what I will do here, I can find there are two keywords. One is the customary morality and other is the modern life. And whether it can be guide or cannot be guide, I will decide later. I'll make this approach later on. So what I will do? I'll take my page where I'm thinking and I will start jotting down what is the meaning and elements of customary morality. I'll find number of things. Like for example, if I just have to think practically, can I say there are various type of customs we are finding? Like for example, can I just think, if I'm just thinking here, like several type of religious customs are there? Can I say that? I will find so many type of social customs are present. Can I say particular type of customs I can talk about, especially with respect to what is the status of women? What is, like for example, I can think about caste. There are so many things. I can keep on thinking, randomly I'll think, okay, what are these customs? How these customs I've seen? And I will keep jotting down. Then what I'll do? I will talk about modern life. I'll think about modern life. And I will think, okay, so many things I know about modern life. Modern life, I know very well, it is guided by technology. Can I say modern life is guided by, very much by economic factors? They have become very, very important. They are dimensions of our life. They pave the way. We are leading our life. We are talking about in modern life, I just think about, okay, I have read about constitution. Constitution wants to make us what? Modern. So many elements of modern life are there. There is sovereignty, there is equality, secularism. Can I say all these are aspects of what? Their modern life. Can we say that? And once I have jotted them down, this is now random list of things which where to think the essay is. And it is very clear now what I have to do. I have to think, I have to look whether, for example, when I'm talking about religion, is it compatible with technology or is it compatible with the economic things which is there? Like for example, if I just give you one example, today there is a phenomena in India where we are finding that there is a kind of violence going on in the name of cow protection. Can I say, I am finding, like for example, modern life, one aspect is environment, economics. So can I say, I will find this type of protection to be It would have its own. There is for and against, no doubt. But can I say I will be finding many things which would be incompatible with the economic of modern life? Like for example, India has limited pasture land. You must have read in your NCERTs. And if there is too much of cattle population or the livestock population which becomes a burden, can I say there would be very fast degradation of these pasture lands? And if there is very fast degradation of these pasture lands, can I say it is not good for the economic of those areas, for the livelihood of the people? Because if you are not slaughtering the cattle which is becoming old and less productive, that means what will happen? The burden for that feed of the cattle would be increasing. It would give lots of pressure on the pasture lands. So what we are finding, it is not good from the economic point of view. Also, it is not compatible from the present environmental needs. Also, it is not compatible with equality, because we are finding that particularly, if you talk about livestock, who are most affected because of the phenomena? Can I say some marginal societies? They are most affected because of the phenomena. So we are finding what? It is not compatible. We'll also be find that there will be some compatibilities, because we have to protect the cattle. Okay, so if I know the process, if I have practiced the process enough, will I be able to, this topic, I am a geography teacher, you all know. Mujhe sahi se pata bhi nahi hai ki what is customary morality, what are the different dimensions of customary morality in the philosophy. You'll find many dimensions, many ideas about customary morality. But still what I will be able to do? I will be able to take this topic because I am every day seeing this phenomena. I am victim of that customary morality. Ghar mein roj mere ko aadha ghanta torture kar rahe hain, shaadi kar lo, shaadi kar lo. But it is not compatible with what is my modern life. I feel that I have to do something. I have to be very economically secure. Then I will be probably going for it. So it is what? There is an element of incompatibility. So I can feel this topic more. So you tell me, you will be more natural in writing such topics or the climate change. Can I say? It is much more closer to me. But why I was afraid? Just after seeing the title, I became what? I became afraid. And why I was afraid? Because again, I haven't been taught to think like this. So once I know all this, I have done this activity, I know very well, I have to take both the sides of the coin. I have to think about for as well as against. I'll have to prove many of the things which are compatible. For example, if you talk about, it is inbuilt in customs, social customs, that people should marry and they should have children. Can I say that if we look the example of China today, China is doing what? China is ultimately towards a process whereby their population is aging very fast. If I look the practical example of the developed countries, I will be finding their population is aging very, very fast. And if everything become too individualistic, can I say such type of problems would arise? Fertility becomes so low that there is even threat. So low fertilities are threat to the society. So there is what? There is an extent. There is also the for idea that it is compatible. Many of the things which are there inbuilt, it is about the progress of the society. So again, what I have to do, it is now becoming very easy for me. I know, I pick the topics, I'll write about how religion, how many social customs, like for example, marriage, I will write a separate paragraph on marriage. So that is what is we have to learn. That is the second step. Third step, once I have decided the paragraph's headings, what I will do in the third step, I'll think about what would be the examples. When in the first class, we'll see that any form of writing is what? It is, I can write simply the general thing, but if I also give elaboration with help of an example, can I say it will give punch to my statement, to my idea? So again, I will think about what I am going to write inside that paragraph and how. What would be the examples that I will be citing? Like I cited many examples now. I'll discuss those examples of how they are compatible, how they are incompatible within the essay. So this is basically what? That is basically essay writing is all about. And in this program, what we are going to do? In this program, we are just going to give you the topics. We will give you those 30 minutes of brainstorming, that 40 minutes. And in those 40 minutes, what will happen? You will be given this task of brainstorming, framing your essay in the class. After that, teachers will come. I will be taking some of the essays. Some other teachers will also be taking. And they will demonstrate you how they would have done brainstorming if they were writing the essay. Whatever content we have to give, we'll be giving through this framework only. So like I said here, I demonstrated here, this is the way I would have solved this question. Thought about this essay. So this we are going to do for so many essays that we'll be discussing. Okay? So it will give you also, you can say, all dimensions, all types. Like for example, we'll take up the social exclusion topic. We'll take up some personal philosophical topics. We'll take up modern topics, climate change. How? We have to think on them. But objective is again what? Giving you that direction rather than teaching you. Trying to ensure that you're developing that ability to take out what is inside you. Okay? And that is why what I have done, the material that you'll be getting, it is not that bulky material. What we'll be giving? About one essay, maximum two and a half page framework, that is. And that too in point framework, that in the introduction, where it is more about discussing that this is the element, this is the need. So here, this should have been done. This was the way we would have written. Okay? So, I don't have to say much about what is we are going to do here. It is all about you practicing. We'll just make you practice so that you develop your own way of writing essay. You have to personalize your way of writing essay. Okay? I'll not speak too much, and you already have the schedule of the program with you. And you can see it is just 4 weeks. Just as I said, objective is to break the inertia. Because even after the program will be over, you will continue to improve. I will be there to support you. If you want to show your essays, which you are even later writing, will be there to help you out in them. Okay? Beside, in the classes, when it will be going on, we'll be there. For the tests, we'll try to evaluate. I will myself, in fact, for the test, we'll do what? That there will be two levels of checking which will be going on. One, the person who is checking, I will also look into the essays which have been written. So there will be two people who will be actually looking into your essay. They will give their independent assessment about how you have written the essay. That is one unique thing that we'll like to introduce in this program. Okay. So if you have any questions regarding this, you have to ask me about this essay program. You can ask me. After that, I'll call Shivansh, and he will give his opinion on what was essay writing about, how he scored good marks. I would like him to tell you how he developed his own personal way of writing essay and how he thinks, and we also feel it was very crucial in him scoring very, very good marks in the essay. Okay, any questions? Okay, Shivansh. Word limit kaise rakhe essay ki? Okay, word limit you will be developing by practice. I think if you are writing somewhere around 1000 to 1200 words, it is enough. Sir, ye bataiye, jaise ki hame pata kaise chalega मतलब ज़्यादा हो गया कम हो गया ये समझ वर्ड लिमिट की बात कर रहे हो यार देखो मतलब इट इज़ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वर्ड लिमिट की जब हम बात करते हैं तो इट इज़ नॉट अबाउट योर एक्चुअल वर्ड लिमिट बिकॉज इट वुड बी वेरिएबल फ्रॉम एसे टू एसे बट अगर मुझे कुछ एवरेज मुझे बताना है तो आई वुड सिंपली से दैट इट वुड रेंज बिटवीन 900 टू 1200 वर्ड्स इससे पहले जाता हूँ कम हो जाता है तो आई एम राइटिंग एक्चुअली लेसर इफ़ आई एम राइटिंग मोर देन आई वुड बी कंज्यूमिंग आई कैन राइट मोर बट आई एम कंज्यूमिंग मोर टाइम विच वुड नॉट बी प्रोडक्टिव फॉर राइटिंग द सेकेंड एस्से बिकॉज वी हैव टू राइट टू एस्से सो आई हैव टू बैलेंस इट आउट ठीक है अब मैं इसी वाले एस्से में अगर मैं बात करूँ तो विच वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट अगर मैं रिलीजन में ही जाऊँ फॉर एग्जाम्पल सो आई कैन टेक मेनी टाइप मेनी एग्जाम्पल्स एंड आई कैन शो हाउ दे आर कंपैटिबल एंड हाउ दे आर इनकम्पैटिबल बट वेन आई नो दैट वन ऑफ माई थीम इज रिलीजन its compatibility and incompatibility with modern life can I say I would have shown my idea with one example of each compatible example incompatible example I would have bit explained it and it is more than enough theek hai so it is more about completion of dimensions rather than the word limit okay if I feel I have completed the dimensions इट इज़ मोर देन एनफ अगर मैंने उसको 800-900 वर्ड्स में भी कर लिया इट इज़ एनफ ओके इट इज़ अप्रिशिएटेड यूपीएससी खुद लिखता है गेजेट में इफ यू सेइंग सी दैट प्रिसाइजनेस एंड ब्रेविटी वुड बी रिवॉर्डेड सो इफ यू आर प्रिसाइज इन पुटिंग योर आइडिया इफ यू आर एबल टू पुट योर आइडिया इन लेसर अमाउंट ऑफ वर्ड्स इट इज़ अप्रिशिएटेड ओके दैट इज हाउ वी डिसाइड ओके शिवांश I would like to invite Shivansh. He will also be there during this essay program to help you out. When you will be joining the program, you can also show your essays to him. He'll be there to evaluate and give his feedbacks on the essay. Okay? So I'll give the mic to him. He has secured this year 77 rank and if we talk about he has scored very very high marks in the essay it has been very decisive in his selection I'll not speak more I'll let him speak
So hello everyone, as sir has already told you, I have secured All India rank 77 this year and my marks in essay were 145. So I will tell you about my approach to essay writing but before that I will also like to tell you some basic things about essay writing because I developed my approach based on those basic understanding of what is the requirement of essay in UPSC. So first thing is that UPSC has four GS papers in which it is testing our knowledge. So essay is not about knowledge. As sir has already told you, it is not about developing content for all the topics. Like what people usually do is that they will have some content for science and technology based essays, some content for other types of essays. But the first thing to learn about essay is that it is not about knowledge. And the second thing is that this used to happen with me, I don't know if it happens with anyone else or not. I used to think that essay is about writing good English. If you write in very flowery language, if you write very flowery sentences, the examiner will get impressed by seeing your essay copy and he will award you very good marks. So initially when I used to practice essay, I used to focus like 20-30% of my focus was on writing good sentences. If I used to find some difficult word in Hindu, I tried to put that word in my essay to impress anyone who is reading my essay. So these two things I tried to unlearn later ki aise cheeze nahi karni hai essay mein. So the basic guide, if you want to know what is the demand of UPSC, you have to read the syllabus. And I have the syllabus with me and it says that you are expected to keep closely to the subject of the essay to arrange ideas in the orderly fashion, and to write concisely. So these three things, if you can understand, it completely gives you the idea of the demand. So first thing is that you have to write very closely to the subject. जो भी टॉपिक होगा ऐसे का, आपके हर पैराग्राफ में ये रिफ्लेक्ट होना चाहिए कि आप उस टॉपिक से रिलेटेड ही बात कर रहे हैं. और टॉपिक जो होता है ऐसे का, इट इज़ नॉट अ सिंगल सेंटेंस, सिंगल वर्ड. कि कुछ मान लो ऐसे आया कि एग्रीकल्चर हैज़ लॉस्ट, एग्रीकल्चर हैज़ इज़ नो मोर अ सोर्स ऑफ सब्सिस्टेंस फॉर इंडियन फार्मर्स. इस तरह से अगर एक ऐसे का टॉपिक आया तो टॉपिक एग्रीकल्चर नहीं है, पूरा सेंटेंस एक टॉपिक है. ये नहीं कि अलग अलग पैराग्राफ में एग्रीकल्चर के बारे में कुछ कुछ लिख दिया, नेगेटिव एस्पेक्ट्स बता दिया एग्रीकल्चर के और बोल दिया कि ये है हमारा टॉपिक. बट उसमें पूरा जो टॉपिक है उसमें ये है कि इट हैज़ लॉस्ट द बीइंग द सोर्स ऑफ सब्सिस्टेंस फॉर फार्मर्स. तो हमें फार्मर्स पे ही फोकस करना है मेनली. ये नहीं दिखाना है उसमें कि और जो एस्पेक्ट्स हैं एग्रीकल्चर के कि और प्रॉब्लम्स, या मान लो एक्सपोर्ट इम्पोर्ट की प्रॉब्लम या जो भी है. तो एक तो सब्जेक्ट आपका हर पैराग्राफ में रिफ्लेक्ट होना चाहिए. अभी मैं एक एग्जांपल के थ्रू बताऊंगा कि कैसे उसे मैं करता था. और दूसरी चीज़ है कि अरेंज आइडियाज़ इन द ऑर्डरली फैशन. तो एक जो कंटिन्यूटी होती है ना ऐसे की, वो मेंटेन रहनी चाहिए. जैसे कुछ लोगों का अप्रोच मैंने पढ़ा था अपनी ऐसे राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस करने से पहले, उन्होंने क्या कहा कि ऐसे का सिंपल यही फंडा है कि जो भी टॉपिक है उसको सोशल एस्पेक्ट्स, इकोनॉमिक एस्पेक्ट्स, एनवायरमेंटल एस्पेक्ट्स, गवर्नेंस एस्पेक्ट्स, 5-6 एक शॉर्ट फॉर्म होता है, उन सब में डिवाइड कर लो. इंटरनेशनल डिमेंशंस 6-7 डिमेंशंस बना लो और हर डिमेंशन पे उस टॉपिक से रिलेटेड कुछ लिख लो. पर वो जो है, अगर इस तरह से ऐसे लिखो तो मेरे हिसाब से वो बहुत बोरिंग सा हो जाता है और एक जीएस आंसर बन जाता है, लंबा सा जीएस आंसर, कि 1000 वर्ड का जीएस आंसर लिख दिया, बहुत सारे फ्रेमवर्क्स कवर कर लिए. बट जैसे कि सर ने बोला था कि एस्से इज़ अ फॉर्म ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन, तो एक तरह से बिना एग्जामिनर से मिले, जो कॉपी चेक कर रहा है, तुम उससे बात कर रहे हो, इट जैसे डिबेट कर रहे हो. तो अगर तुम किसी स्पीकर को बोलते हुए भी सुनो, तो कोई एक स्पीकर है जो अपनी स्पीच में बिल्कुल इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स बताए जा रहा है, इकोनॉमिक फैक्ट्स बताए जा रहा है, ये बोल रहा है, वो बोल रहा है, जो कि बहुत ही इम्पॉर्टेंट डेटा है, लोग उसकी बात से ज़्यादा आकर्षित होते हैं ऐसे इंसान की बात से जो कि ऐसी बात कर रहा है जो उनके दिल पे कुछ हो रही है या उस तरह की बातें. तो यही सेम चीज़ ऐसे में भी अप्लाई होती है कि यू हैव टू कम्युनिकेट डायरेक्टली विद द एग्जामिनर एंड वट एवर द टॉपिक ऑफ द ऐसे इज़, यू हैव टू शो हिम वॉट इज़ योर पर्सनल टेक ऑन द टॉपिक. So apart from that, and the other thing is that the length of essay, as sir has told you, ki around 1000 words ka essay hota hai, to usi se hame demand samajh mein aa jani chahiye, kyunki GS paper mein around 20 questions hote hain, agar 200 words bhi sab mein likho to 4000 words in 3 hours. Essay ke paper mein 2 essays, 1000 words means 2000 words in 3 hours. To time bahut zyada hota hai aapke paas, ki aap aaram se sochiye. यहाँ पे उस चीज़ की कोई रेस नहीं है कि कौन जल्दी लिख लेता है अपनी थॉट्स को. आराम से सोचिए, डीप जाइए टॉपिक में, और फिर जो आपके आइडियाज़ हैं उसको रिफ्लेक्ट करिए. तो इस तरह की अप्रोच ऐसे में रखनी है. और बाकी जो जितना नॉलेज पार्ट चाहिए होता है ऐसे के लिए, वो हमें अपने डेली लाइफ एक्सपीरियंसेस से और जितनी हम जीएस की प्रिपरेशन करते हैं उससे भी हमारी नॉलेज बढ़ती है. और एक होती है ना डायरेक्ट फैक्चुअल नॉलेज, वो वाली नॉलेज नहीं, एक होती है कि चीज़ों के लिए प्रति समझ बढ़ जाती है. चीज़ें जो होती हैं दुनिया में क्या चल रहा है वो हमें अच्छे से समझ में आता है. उसी थिंकिंग को ऐसे में रिफ्लेक्ट करना होता है. तो और फिर उसके बाद अब मैं अपनी ऐसे की प्रिपरेशन के बारे में बताता हूँ. क्योंकि मेरा फर्स्ट अटैम्प्ट था तो मेरे पास भी ज़्यादा टाइम नहीं था ऐसे की प्रिपरेशन के लिए. So what I did was initially I wrote 2-3 essays, one on agriculture because I had geography optional. So initially I also had that inclination of finding topics related to geography because I thought I already had a lot of content in geography. So I will choose that and write very different things, lot of things about land reforms, problems, environmental problems, everything. And then I gave it to my friends who were preparing since last 3-4 years and were scoring very good marks. 140 plus marks in essay. So they also gave me the same feedback. One thing was also that whatever statement I was seeing in the essay topic, मुझे ऐसा लगता था कि या तो इससे agree करना है या तो इससे disagree करना है. पहले मन ये बनाना है कि agree या disagree, उसके बाद फिर उस हिसाब से search करना है. But it is not important कि you have to take a side, it is not a debate. You can partially agree with the statement. For example, the statement was customary morality cannot be the guide to modern life. So you can say that customary morality cannot be the sole guide. There are other factors which are guiding the modern lifestyle, but we can also take certain good things from the customary morality and try to apply it in the modern lifestyle. When you make your own thesis statement like this, in this opinion of yours, you can write both the for points and the against points. In the four points, you will say ki these things are good about customary morality, so these should guide the modern life, and these are certain things which may not be required in the modern lifestyles, and customary morality should also change with times or something like that. You can approach your essay and then you can divide it on different subtopics. So try to, whatever the topic is, whether it is a negative topic or a positive topic, try to take some certain positive things out of it and either agree with it partially or totally, whatever it is. For example, jo maine aise likha tha, it was a good life is one inspired by love and guided by knowledge. So usme mujhe kuch aisa disagreement jaisa laga nahi, so I totally agreed with the statement aur uska approach main batata hu. तो मैं जो बता रहा था कि मैंने एग्रीकल्चर पे ऐसे लिखा ऑप्शनल, अपने ऑप्शनल के टॉपिक से रिलेटेड, तो फीडबैक मुझे यही मिला कि बहुत ही ज़्यादा मैकेनिकल बोरिंग सा ऐसे है, और मैं बस अलग अलग पैराग्राफ्स में कुछ कुछ लिख रहा हूँ, एक कनेक्टेड ऐसे भी नहीं बन रहा है. ऐसे में दूसरी इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ ये भी है कि काफ़ी कनेक्टेड होना चाहिए. जहाँ पर आपका लास्ट पैराग्राफ ख़त्म हो रहा है और जहाँ पर आपका नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ स्टार्ट हो रहा है, वो दो बिल्कुल अलग अलग चीज़ें नहीं होनी चाहिए. एक कंटिन्यूटी मेंटेन होनी चाहिए कि जैसे कोई बात भी करता है तो ऐसे नहीं होता है कि आज अभी अचानक से सोशल एस्पेक्ट्स की बात की, पैराग्राफ खत्म किया, अब बोला नहीं अब इंटरनेशनल डायमेंशन की बात करेंगे. पर क्यों, इस कुछ होना चाहिए कुछ कंटिन्यूटी कि इस टॉपिक, इस पैराग्राफ के बाद ही ये पैराग्राफ क्यों, ये पैराग्राफ पहले क्यों नहीं था. तो एक तो कंटिन्यूटी मेंटेन करनी है और हर पैराग्राफ में टॉपिक से जुड़कर रहना है. तो इस चीज़ में बहुत प्रॉब्लम भी होती है, कहने में बहुत आसान लगता है पर जब ऐसे लिखो तो कई बार हमें जो याद आ रहा होता है हमें वो लिखने का मन करता है, कई बार ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग में अच्छे एग्जांपल्स याद नहीं आते हैं. तो उस इस चीज़ से बचने के लिए मैंने अपना एक फ्रेमवर्क बनाया था. उसमें यह था कि एसे का जो टॉपिक होगा, फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ तो इंट्रोडक्शन ही होता है, उसमें दो तीन अप्रोचेज होती हैं, या तो कुछ लोग उस टॉपिक से रिलेटेड स्टोरी लिख देते हैं उस टॉपिक को जस्टिफाई करने के लिए. स्टोरी अगर कोई रियल लाइफ स्टोरी याद है तो वो लिख दो, नहीं याद है तो बनाकर भी लिख सकते हो, या फिर नॉर्मली उस चीज़ को डिफाइन करने से स्टार्ट कर दो, या कोई कोट है तो उससे और फिर कोट से क्या समझ में आ रहा है उस तरह से स्टार्ट कर दो. तो फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ ख़त्म होने के बाद, जैसे फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ ख़त्म होने के बाद जो सेकेंड पैराग्राफ था उसमें मैं बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस पूछता था कि जब तुम कोई टॉपिक देखो तो तुम्हारे दिमाग में कुछ क्वेश्चंस आएंगे, तो वही क्वेश्चंस मैं उसमें लिख देता था और फिर बोलता था कि नाउ वी विल ट्राई टू फाइंड द आंसर्स ऑफ ऑल दिस क्वेश्चंस इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ अवर एसे. फॉर एग्जांपल, जैसे अ गुड लाइफ इज़ वन इंस्पायर्ड बाय लव एंड गाइडेड बाय नॉलेज, तो मैंने फिर बेसिक क्वेश्चंस यही आते हैं कि व्हाट इज गुड लाइफ, गुड लाइफ वेरीज फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन. किसी मॉन्क के लिए गुड लाइफ जो है वो पहाड़ों में जा करके है, किसी बहुत उस तरह की लेविश लाइफ जीने वाले के लिए बहुत सारी कार्स खरीदना, शॉपिंग करना, उसमें गुड लाइफ है. गुड लाइफ वेरीज फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन. आइडिया ऑफ नॉलेज ऑल्सो वेरीज फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन. कैसी नॉलेज, क्या नॉलेज मीन्स एजुकेशन, लिटरेट होना इज अ नॉलेज, और समवन हु हैज लर्न फ्रॉम हिज एक्सपीरियंस इज ऑल्सो नॉलेज. एंड देन हाउ दिस नॉलेज लव is related to good life. Let us suppose if you only have knowledge and you don't have the understanding of love. Love is aise mein jo matlab tha basically emotional content within a person. Emotional connect with your outside world, with you. To ab ek paragraph mein maine bola I will discuss if we are only inspired by love but we are not guided by knowledge, will we have a good life? In the next paragraph, we will discuss if we are guided by knowledge but are not inspired by life, will we have a good life? And उसके बाद third paragraph में भी इसी तरह से कुछ लिखा था. तो इस तरह से बहुत सारे questions मैं पूछ लेता था. तो questions जो होते थे वो वही होता था जो main terms हैं topic के, उनकी definitions, उनको किस किस angle से देखा जा सकता है. तो और इस चीज़ के लिए ना फिलोसफिकल टॉपिक अगर ऐसे का उठाओ तो ही ये चीज़ ज़्यादा अच्छे से इम्प्लीमेंट हो सकती है. अब तुम एग्रीकल्चर के ऐसे में नहीं लिख सकते वी लास्ट व्हाट इज़ एग्रीकल्चर, हु इज़ फार्मर, तो इस तरह से नहीं. तो ये चीज़ थी कि मैं डिसाइड करके गया था कि अगर फिलोसफिकल ऐसे हमेशा 5 में से 1 होता ही है आएगा तो मैं वही टॉपिक चूज़ करूँगा. और उसी में लिखने की कोशिश करूंगा। और अप्रोच ऐसी होनी चाहिए कंटेंट की और इंग्लिश की कि क्लास टेंथ का बच्चा अगर तुम्हारा ऐसे पढ़े तो उसे एक एक वर्ड समझ में आए, चीज़ें सारी समझ में आए। उस तरह से सिंपल लैंग्वेज और सिंपल बातें ही लिखनी होती हैं। जितना ज़्यादा सिंपल एग्जाम्पल से किसी चीज़ को समझाया जाए ना, कि बिल्कुल एकदम मान लो कि एक स्ट्रीट डॉग का एग्जाम्पल लेकर के कि हाउ हिज लाइफ इज़ गाइडेड बाय लव, तो वो लोगों को ज़्यादा अट्रैक्ट करता है, ना कि यू टेक एग्जाम्पल फ्रॉम हिस्ट्री कि नेपोलियन ने ऐसा किया था और इसलिए गुड लाइफ इज इंस्पायर्ड बाय दिस दैट। तो जितना ज़्यादा रियल लाइफ एग्जाम्पल, तो उससे एक कम्युनिकेट ये होता है एग्जामिनर को कि वी आर लुकिंग अराउंड अवर वर्ल्ड और हम उसमें रिफ्लेक्ट कर रहे हैं और ऐसे में आया तो वहीं का वहीं सोच रहे हैं, ना कि किसी बुक से पढ़ के आए हैं कि भाई थोड़ा हिस्ट्री का देना है, टच उसका देना है। तो आफ्टर आस्किंग दीज क्वेश्चन मेरे पास एक फ्रेमवर्क बन जाता था कि अब अगले 5-6 पैराग्राफ में ये लिखना है, और फिर उन पैराग्राफ्स के लिए मैं एग्जाम्पल सर्च करता था जो ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंग का टाइम है, कि इफ़ आई हैव टू शो कि अगर लाइफ इज़ ओनली इंस्पायर्ड बाई नॉलेज एंड देर इज़ नो लव तो क्या होगा। फॉर एग्जाम्पल उसमें मैं हिटलर का एग्जाम्पल दे सकता हूँ या किसी ऐसे उसका एग्जाम्पल दे सकता हूँ हु हैड अ पर्सन हु हैड अ लॉट ऑफ नॉलेज बट ही ऑल्सो हैड अ लॉट ऑफ हेट्रेड टुवर्ड सोसाइटी, दैट्स वाई ही डिड वेरी रॉन्ग थिंग्स विच ही शुड नॉट हैव डन। इफ नॉलेज वॉज सफिशियंट देन ही माइट हैव हैड अ गुड लाइफ, तो उस तरह से एग्जाम्पल दे सकता हूँ। सिमिलरली दूसरे पैराग्राफ में जिसमें था कि इंस्पायर्ड बाई लव, तो उसमें जैसे एग्जाम्पल मैंने दिया था कि मदर चाइल्ड का रिलेशनशिप जो होता है वो इज़ टोटली इंस्पायर्ड बाय लव, तो उसमें क्या होता है कि कई बार ऐसा होता है कि माँ अपने बच्चों की गलतियों को इग्नोर कर देती है, तो बट इट इज़ नॉट अ गुड थिंग टू डू। अगर इफ़ यू हैव द राइट नॉलेज कि अभी कोई बच्चे ने कुछ शैतानी की, कोई गलती की, तो उसको सही चीज़ सिखाना ज़रूरी है, नॉट गेटिंग टू मच इन टू लव कि उसी का साइड लेना है हमेशा, तो योर चाइल्ड विल हैव अ गुड लाइफ इन फ्यूचर। तो इस तरह से पेरेंटिंग का एग्जाम्पल, सोसाइटी के लिए एग्जाम्पल, गुड नॉलेज अगर इंडिविजुअल लेवल पे भी उसका एग्जाम्पल मैंने लिया था कि नॉलेज अबाउट अवर ओन बॉडी, इफ वी लव अवर बॉडी, इफ वी हैव राइट नॉलेज अबाउट अवर बॉडी वी विल नॉट गेट इनटू सब्सटेंस अब्यूज, इस तरह की चीज़ें। तो उस तरह के बहुत ही बेसिक एग्जाम्पल लेकर के मैंने ये चीज़ बार बार बताने की कोशिश की कि सिर्फ नॉलेज है तो भी काम नहीं चलेगा, सिर्फ लव है तो भी काम नहीं चलेगा, उनका अच्छा मिक्सचर होना चाहिए तो ही काम चलेगा। और उसको बस एग्जाम्पल्स के थ्रू करते करते और कंटिन्यूटी मेंटेन करने के लिए अभी बताता हूँ क्या करते हैं। तो एक तो ये चीज़ हो गई कि क्वेश्चंस पूछ लो और उससे एक फ्रेमवर्क बन जाता है। अब कंटिन्यूटी मेंटेन करने के लिए एक चीज़ तो ये है कि जो लास्ट लाइन पैराग्राफ की ख़त्म हो रही है ना, उसमें नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ की थोड़ी हिंट दे दो कि भाई अब नॉलेज की बात ख़त्म हो गई है, नाउ वी विल फोकस ऑन लव, या फिर मान लो कि लास्ट पैराग्राफ जिस चीज़ से एंड करो नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेंट बट से स्टार्ट करो, बट ऐसा ऐसा भी हो सकता है, तो उससे लगेगा कि बात जो है वो ख़त्म नहीं हुई, वहाँ पे एक बात रुकी थी वही बात स्टार्ट हो रही है। उसके लिए कनेक्टिंग वर्ड्स होते हैं हाउएवर, बट, देयरफॉर, इन सब वर्ड्स से मैं कोशिश करता था कि मेरा नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ स्टार्ट हो, ना कि एक नया इंट्रोडक्शन ही आ जाए नए पैराग्राफ में किसी नई चीज़ का। तो ये सब कुछ बेसिक चीज़ें थी। बाकी एक ऐसे मैंने प्रैक्टिस के टाइम पर लिखा था, 2-3 साल पहले का टॉपिक था, जॉय इज़ द सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड। तो ये भी बहुत ही सिंपल सा टॉपिक है, टॉपिक भी मैं ऐसे ही चूज़ करता था कि जिसमें क्लास टेंथ के बच्चे को दे दो तो वो भी कुछ लिख सकता है, इसमें कोई ऐसी नॉलेज नहीं चाहिए कि क्लाइमेट चेंज क्यों कैसे हो रहा है या क्या हैं चीज़ें। तो जॉय इज़ सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड बहुत सिंपल सा टॉपिक था। इसमें एक स्टोरी से मैंने स्टार्ट किया कि स्टोरी थी कुछ, वो इतनी अच्छी नहीं थी, पर जैसे कि एक म्यूजिशियन है, वो म्यूज़िक परफॉर्म करता है, तो जो वो फिर फाइनली जो ग्रेटिट्यूड ऑडियंस देती है उसे, वो उसके लिए वही होता है जब लोग चीयर करते हैं, उसके म्यूज़िक को एंजॉय करते हैं जॉयफुली, या सर हैं, सर पढ़ाते हैं, तो उसके बाद जब उनके स्टूडेंट सिलेक्ट होते हैं, वो उनकी आंखों में खुशी देखते हैं, जॉय देखते हैं, तो इट इज़ फॉर हिम द बेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड दैट ही कैन एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम हिज स्टूडेंट्स। सो और इस ऐसे में ये नहीं था कि जॉय इज़ अ फॉर्म ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड, इट इज़ द सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड। तो वाई इज़ इट द सिंपलेस्ट, बिकॉज इफ़ यू हैव टू से थैंक यू टू एनीवन, यू विल नीड सम लैंग्वेज। मान लो कि तुम चाइनीज़ आती है तो तुम चाइनीज़ में थैंक यू बोलोगे, जैपनीज़ में, बट इफ़ यू कैन हैव अ स्माइल ऑन योर फेस दैट इज़ इनफ टू कम्युनिकेट टू द अदर पर्सन कि यू आर फीलिंग वेरी मच ओवरवेल्म्ड बाय वॉट एवर ही हैज़ डन फॉर यू। तो इसीलिए इट इज़ द सिंपलेस्ट थिंग, इट नीड्स नो लैंग्वेज, इवन एनिमल्स कैन एक्सप्रेस जॉय टू ह्यूमन्स। जब व्हेन अ डॉग गेट्स हैप्पी ही मूव्स हिज टेल अराउंड, So through this behavior, many other animals also express joy by different behavior. So that is why it is such a form that animal-human relationship can also go through joy. So these kinds of examples I try to learn, and when I finish the first paragraph of agreeing with the statement, I again asked a few questions, because this was my approach. So what is joy? Are there many forms of joy? For example, there is inner joy as well as external joy. Different forms of gratitude. Why is it the simplest form? Are there any other ways of expressing gratitude which are better than joy? So these kinds of questions I asked, and then on the subsequent paragraphs, I tried to answer those questions. So this was my approach. But because this was my first attempt and I also had very limited amount of time to prepare for essays, so I was able to only prepare for philosophical type of essays, ki ye meri approach hogi. But UPSC is very unpredictable, so maybe this year all the essays were philosophical, maybe next year no essay is philosophical. So better thing is to have 3-4 type of techniques. Jaise aur logon ki bhi alag alag type ki hoti hai ki they try to, for example, customary morality wala hai, usme us essay mein puri ek story hi likhi ja sakti hai, essay puri story se hi ban sakta hai, of a society where there is no customary morality. Usme dikhate jao kaise kaise ho raha hai, kya ho raha hai. To ye to thoda difficult approach ho gaya, but aur bhi approaches hoti hain log jo follow karte hain. Ye hai, aur koi question hai to puch sakte ho. क्योंकि ये मैंने अपनी प्रैक्टिस के टाइम पे ऑब्जर्व किया था, जब मैं ऐसे की प्रैक्टिस करता था ना, जिस टॉपिक के बारे में मुझे देख के लगता था मुझे सबसे कम आता है, उसी टॉपिक में मैं अच्छा ऐसे लिख पाता था. क्योंकि आना ना आना, जब हम सोचते हैं ना, तो हम सोचते हैं हमने क्या पढ़ा है बुक्स में और हमें क्या नॉलेज है. तो जब हम ये सोच के कोई ऐसे लिखते हैं तो हम फिर वही बुकिश नॉलेज लिखते हैं. जिस टॉपिक के बारे में हमें लगता है ना कि हमें नहीं आता है, उस टॉपिक के बारे में हमें सोचना पड़ता है कि अब नहीं आता है तो सोचते हैं. जब हम सोचते हैं तो फिर अपनी रियल लाइफ से थोड़े एग्जांपल्स, एक्सपीरियंसेस, ये सब करते हैं. इसे अगर खुद से प्रैक्टिस करो पहली बार में तो बहुत टाइम लगेगा, इसीलिए अगर 3-4 ऐसे में प्रैक्टिस करो, जैसे कि मैंने जॉय वाला लिख रखा था, इसलिए मुझे वहाँ पे गुड लाइफ इज इंस्पायर्ड बाय नॉलेज में बहुत फ़ायदा हुआ. कई सारे तो एग्जाम्पल्स भी सेम इसमें इसके उसमें लग गए, तो लेकिन वो रियल लाइफ एग्जाम्पल्स थे. मैंने घर पर बैठ के सेम चीज़ को ज़्यादा टाइम में किया था, तो वहाँ पर कम टाइम में हो गई. और 30 मिनट के टाइम में यू गेट सफिशेंट टाइम टू थिंक. अगर तुम्हें अपनी नॉलेज से ही लिखना होता तो ऐसे 3000 वर्ड्स का होता, तो शायद मैं अपने ज्योग्राफिकली ऐसे लिखता कि वहाँ जाके सोचने का तो टाइम है नहीं, ज्योग्राफी आती है तो उसी का ऐसे लिख देता हूँ. तो यही मेन इशू है. जब तुम यू शुड ऑल्सो ट्राई टू राइट 2-3 essays, 1 फ्रॉम ज्योग्राफी, 1 फ्रॉम समथिंग एल्स, एनी टॉपिक विच यू फील अबाउट बट नॉट पर्टिकुलरली रिलेटेड टू ज्योग्राफी. यू विल ऑब्जर्व दैट एंड ट्राई टू टेक पर्सनल फीडबैक इन एसेज ऑलवेज. जो ऐसे की टेस्ट सीरीज होती हैं उसमें तो कुछ कुछ फीडबैक मिलेगा ही, बट फ्रेंड्स को दिखा के या सर के पास पर्सनली जाके, क्योंकि जब कोई ऐसे पढ़ के तुम्हारा पूरा स्टार्टिंग से एंड तक रिव्यू देता है ना, तो वो पर्सनल फीडबैक जो होता है बहुत वैल्यूएबल होता है. कम नंबर ऑफ एसेज प्रैक्टिस करो, पर सब में डिटेल्ड फीडबैक लो, अलग अलग लोगों से सेम चीज़ के लिए फीडबैक लो, तो बहुत सारी चीज़ें सामने आती हैं कि ये प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, और उन प्रॉब्लम्स को ध्यान में रखते हुए नेक्स्ट टाइम से करने की कोशिश करो. और दूसरी चीज़ प्रैक्टिस के लिए, मैं ब्लॉग भी लिखता था, ऑनलाइन ब्लॉग्स लिखता था. उसमें जो भी खुद से मन करता था टॉपिक, वो न्यूज़ में जो भी चल रहा है, कोई भी इशू है, काउ से रिलेटेड, काउ विजिलेंटिज्म से रिलेटेड इशू है, या फिर ट्रिपल तलाक इशू है, कोई भी इशू है, उसमें लिखता था. और उसमें भी कंटेंट पर फोकस नहीं करता था, मेन फोकस मेरा होता था कि जो भी मैंने सेंटेंस बनाया है वही सेंटेंस रिफ्लेक्ट हो हर पैराग्राफ में, और हर पैराग्राफ कंटिन्यूस हो विदाउट ड्रिफ्टिंग अवे फ्रॉम द टॉपिक. तो ये दो जो सोल पिलर्स हैं ऐसे के, इन्हें कहीं मतलब यही हमें करना होता है, इसी की प्रैक्टिस. ऐसे लिखने स्टार्ट करने से पहले भी पता होता है कि टॉपिक से ड्रिफ्ट नहीं करना है और कंटिन्यूटी मेंटेन करनी है, पर वो लिखते लिखते बीच में ड्रिफ्ट हो जाती है अगर ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग अच्छे से ना की हो तो. तो इसी चीज़ की प्रैक्टिस करनी है. जब ये दोनों चीज़ें ऐसे में रिफ्लेक्ट होने लगेंगी तो विद सम गुड एग्जाम्पल्स, तो ऐसे अपने आप अच्छा लगने लगेगा. ऐसे लिखना तो पर्सनल होता है, कुछ लोग किस लेवल पे हैं आप उससे समझ में आता है. मैंने तो पूरा एक साल से रेगुलरली 15 दिन में एक ब्लॉग लिख देता था कि राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस भी होती रहेगी और चीज़ें पता चलती रहेंगी। जब इनिशियल फर्स्ट ऐसे लिखो ना, उससे खुद को जज करो, लोगों को दिखाओ, सर से पूछो कि कितनी ज़रूरत है इंप्रूवमेंट की, उससे पता चलेगा। क्योंकि कुछ लोग बहुत अच्छा ऐसे लिख लेते हैं ऐसे ही, कुछ लोग नहीं लिखते हैं। जैसे कि मुझे प्रॉब्लम थी कि मैं बहुत ज़्यादा टेक्निकल और उस तरह से लिखता था, तो फिर मैंने अपनी ब्लॉग में भी अप्रोच को चेंज की। पहले मैं ब्लॉग के टॉपिक्स भी ऐसे लेता था, नेशनल हेल्थ पॉलिसी, अब उस पर लिख दिया जो भी मन किया। तो इट इज़ नॉट अ टॉपिक, इसमें कुछ प्रैक्टिस है नहीं, यू आर राइटिंग नॉलेज अबाउट नेशनल हेल्थ पॉलिसी। देन आई शिफ्टेड द टॉपिक्स आई यूज टू सिलेक्ट, टॉपिक्स कुछ सेंटेंस वाले ना, जिस जो दे आर आस्किंग सम क्वेश्चन, जैसे यूपीएससी में देता है, और यूपीएससी के लास्ट 5 ईयर के पेपर्स देख के ही ऐसे के इतने टॉपिक्स मिल जाते हैं। बट रिगार्डिंग टाइम ऐसे यार बताना डिफिकल्ट है, प्रीलिम्स के बाद वैसे भी ज़्यादा टाइम मिलता नहीं इन सब चीज़ों के लिए, तो प्रीलिम्स से पहले ही प्रैक्टिस कर लो तो ज़्यादा अच्छा है, और रेगुलरली करते रहो। हाँ, ऐसे हेडिंग डाल डाल के ऐसे कुछ लोग लिखते हैं, बट आई वुड सजेस्ट कि ऐसे ना लिखो। मतलब आई डोंट थिंक कि ऐसे ऐसे में बहुत अच्छे मार्क्स मिल सकते हैं। कि फॉर एग्जांपल कुछ टॉपिक आ गया आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस या कुछ भी, अब उसमें लिख दिया आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस का इकोनॉमी पे क्या असर पड़ेगा, गवर्नेंस पे क्या असर पड़ेगा, सोशल इश्यूज़ में, सोशल रिलेशंस में क्या असर पड़ेगा, तो इस तरह से लिख सकते हो, पर वो उतना अच्छा इंप्रेशन नहीं देगा ऐसे का। जीएस का आंसर की तरह लगेगा कि यू हैव नॉलेज अबाउट एवरीथिंग सो यू हैव रिटन इट, उस तरह से लगेगा। मतलब अगर जैसे आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस का क्वेश्चन आता है, तो उसमें तुम अपना कुछ खुद से सोच पाओ कि अगर आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस आ गया तो क्या क्या दुनिया में बदलाव आ जाएंगे। उन 30 मिनट में सोचो खुद से, जो पढ़ा है उसे भूल करके, कि क्या क्या हो सकता है, क्या क्या काम आसान हो सकते हैं, क्या क्या दिक्कतें मुश्किल आ सकती हैं, उस हिसाब से लिखो तो थोड़े और अच्छा इंप्रेशन पड़ेगा। अगर लिखना भी है ऐसे में, तो बिना सब हेडिंग डाले, अगर तुम्हें एक टॉपिक, एक पैराग्राफ में इकोनॉमिक इश्यूज लिखने हैं, एक पैराग्राफ में ये लिखना है, तो उसे थोड़ा फनी वे में, या मतलब थोड़ा अच्छे से लिख करके कर सकते हैं, ना कि सिंपल स्टेटमेंट्स लिख दें कि इस इतनी जो है प्रोडक्टिविटी, लेबर प्रोडक्टिविटी बढ़ जाएगी। तो ऐसे वर्ड जो है ना, लेबर प्रोडक्टिविटी, इन सब वर्ड से बचना है, क्योंकि सिंपल लैंग्वेज में सिंपल बात लिखनी है। यार ब्लॉग जो था वो मैंने अभी बंद कर रखा है। थैंक यू।
ओके फ्रेंड्स, सो वील कंक्लूड दिस सेमिनार ऑन एसे। On the first class, you will be finding I'll be talking about number of things. I was just very, very brief and fast. Here, I'll be talking about how to use the language. For example, we'll see how connectivity can be maintained with the use of conjunctions, how to use adjectives and adverbs to ultimately sometimes even beautify the statements or make them more powerful. Okay. So again, we'll talk about so many details. How to do the brainstorming, how to, what type of introductions can be written, what type of conclusions can be written. For example, one way of writing the essay is like already having a conclusion in the mind. If we'll see, it is a very, very powerful technique. For example, when I'm brainstorming, and after brainstorming, what I have done, first level, I have already decided the conclusion. So when I have already decided the conclusion, I know where I have to go. So if I know where I have to go, I will be going on that side, I will be writing along. And if I am doing so, can I say it is inevitable that I will be able to maintain the continuity? It will naturally bring out the continuity if I have already decided the conclusion. Okay. So we will see that there are many ways in which we can maintain continuity in the first class. That first class is devoted to that only. Okay. After that, it would be only and only practice, maximum amount of practice, so that we are able to learn number of ways of writing essays. Because that is why I said that not only I will be taking the classes, there will be other teachers also coming. They will tell their own view, because there are so many variety of views. Okay. So you'll be learning number of techniques and you'll be practicing them. More importantly, that would be the practice. Okay. Okay.